Epilogue. It had been days since Tian had started his volunteer teaching job, thanks to Kama being less help. The village chief told him that when he had called Pru Vinay, the foundation director, the man wasn't surprised and said he would send them a credential letter. His pupils had grown up. The older ones became more fluent in Thai, and new faces were joining the class. Tian was having a headache. He hadn't prepared any lessons, just like the first time. So he asked them to draw and make toys, the only two things he was good at teaching, to keep them occupied and see what the previous teacher had left off from the textbooks in the cabinet. Captain Pupa, no, he was now Major Pupa, was busy handing over his jobs to the new captain at the base they rarely met. He wasn't lonely or sulky, though. After that evening on Papandao's cliff, where they had poured their hearts to each other, he became awkward around the other men, to his surprise. Later this afternoon, the young man borrowed a plastic basin from Kama Bingle to wash his clothes at the waterfall under the scorching sun. He found a good spot and sat down under a canopy, using fragrant herbal soap to scrub on his expensive clothes, not worrying they would be ruined. After scrubbing the fabrics for half an hour, he broke out into a sweat and lost his patience. "Too fucking hot!" He shut up, pulling his shirt and taking off the jeans, leaving only a boxer on, not caring if it offend the forest spirits. The lean, firm body jumped into the basin where the cascade hit, and the half-naked Tian was swimming in the cool water until he caught the sight of a tall man on a large boulder. The man was crossing his arms, staring. The officer was frowning as he watched and started reprimanding.
"Why did you get a bare ass like that? What if some young girls stumble upon you? That would be against the norm."
The younger man wasn't fazed and grinned. "So what? I can marry her and live here forever." Tian swam towards Major Pupa, whose face darkened, and gave him a sweet smile. "I was kidding. Come on. Everyone is working at the plantation. That's why I came here to wash the clothes." He chose the hour where the sun was right above their heads because the women often come to take water or wash the clothes at dawn. The weather was mild during those hours. He reached out at the officer and said sweetly, "Pull me, please." The intense dark eyes glared at him for a moment before yielding. Pupa crouched down and gave the younger man his hand. Tian seized it and pulled him into the water, where Pupa toppled down with a loud splash. The tall officer emerged from the water and bore his fangs at the younger man, who was laughing, pleased.
"Why did you do that?"
"I'm afraid you'll have a stroke from the stress. You always look constipated." Even if Tian was playing nice, his wicked smile betrayed him.
"Did you have enough fun? Come here."
Pupa lunged forward and grabbed the slim waist. Tian was struggling, but the major spun him around. The naked skin pressing tight to the green khaki t-shirt created physical friction that made Tian stop breathing. Their faces were a breath apart. Their eyes that met spoke a thousand silent words. The fair face inched away as the older man leaned down and the thick lips pressed on the smooth cheek. The light, soapy scent on the clear skin drew the tip of the major's straight nose to wander until he reached the back of the younger man's ear. Tian shut his eyes as goosebumps rose all over him. Okay, he knew that their relationship needed to take the next step, and they couldn't keep it at hand or forehead kissing forever. They were both men, and they knew what men wanted. But this was freaking embarrassing. He pushed the major's face away and pretended to whine. "You're shameless! Let me go!" Pupa looked at the boy's cheeks that were turning red, and he smiled, pleased. Yet, he kept his arms tight around him.
"Didn't someone say he wanted me to never let him go?"
The city boy's mouth was agape, not expecting such promise to bite him back in the rear. His soft brown eyes narrowed with frustration. "So you'd better tie me up with you and bring me along on battlefield?"
"Nah,"
the officer objected, finishing with words that made the younger man want to run off with a bomb.
"I'd better tie you up at my bed."
"Captain!" Tian cried out, pushing himself away from the big officer with hands and feet until he broke free from the embrace and climbed up the shore. Pupa chuckled throatily. Even if he was no longer a captain, he still liked it more when Tian called him that way. No matter how much time had gone by, he would always be captain to this special someone. Kama Bing Le exclaimed as he saw the soaking wet major walk side by side with the sulky teacher. He put down the potato he was peeling and invited them to change the clothes in his house. He took the opportunity to lend the teacher his son's hill tribe costumes, knowing the boy didn't bring many clothes with him on this unexpected journey. Both young men raised their hands into a Y, thanking Kama for his help, and returned to the teacher's rundown hut that the mechanic soldiers had restored to a good living condition a few days earlier. The hut became alive with the constant bickering between the two men. The aroma of fried morning glory and omelette emanated from under the hut's open space where someone was cooking dinner. Tian put the rice pot with a bean on the litter where dishes of simple food were. Soon afterward, Pupa, dressed in Akha clothes, showed up with a plate of spicy boiled egg salad. The young major had dinner with the teacher every evening and stayed to chat with him until late, then left. Tomorrow was a day off, and he wouldn't miss the opportunity to ask to spend a night here. Pupa put the spicy egg salad into his lover's dish.
"Have a bite. I didn't put too much chili in it."
Any food was good with hot rice. Tian scooped the egg into his mouth, chewing happily, and put the fried morning glory he made into the major's dish. But instead of getting a happy reaction, the officer was acting as if he was swallowing a bitter pill.
"Why are you making a face? You're rude."
"I saw how you put half a bottle of fish sauce."
"I didn't put it. It spilled."
He scooped the veggie and pushed it towards the officer's lips, forcing him to take it.
"I made this. You're not going to eat it?"
The indestructible warrior finally yielded, not being able to fight against the plea. He opened his mouth for the morning glory in a fish sauce that made his eyes water, but he managed to swallow everything without a single complaint.
"Isn't it sweet?"
The rascal grinned, pleased that he finally got back at the officer.
"Whatever you make is sweet."
Hearing such sappy words from the poker face made Tian nauseated.
"Enough, Captain. I'm not going anywhere, so cut this up."
"We'll find out if you're not really going anywhere tonight."
Meeting the major's bright eyes made him look down as he continued with his food, shutting up and not wanting to bicker any further. A chill ran down his spine as a hunch crept in. The word "tonight" was a confirmation that he wasn't going anywhere, indeed. The light from the kerosene lamp was dimmed, but the room was dark and only the silhouettes could be seen. The lean form that turned his back towards the door inside the mosquito net sighed softly, watching his watch as relief washed over him. The man who had asked to spend the night with him left to talk to Kama Bing Le since evening, and he didn't return even if it was already 11. He pulled a thin blanket over him, covering his body from head to toe. Even if it was summer, the temperature on the hill was still cold. Knowing he was getting away tonight, the young man quickly fell asleep. Near midnight, heavy footsteps were coming up the stairs, but the sleeping man wasn't roused. The tall form leaned down to whisper in his ear.
If you're not awake, I can't promise you'll be fine.
As soon as the words trailed off, the almond eyes flew open. What? Tian gasped, alarmed, and rolled around to face the major. Strong arms wrapped around his thin waist and pulled him tight.
He came back late.
If I came back early, we would start early. You like that better?
Wuka teased the man in his arms. Tian swallowed thickly.
Does it have to be tonight?
The tan face leaned in and the major pressed a comforting kiss on the younger man's lips.
We can try. If you don't like it, we'll stop.
That was the worst foreplay he'd ever heard. Tian took in a deep breath. All right, so be it. He closed his eyes, letting the first and the last man he'd ever loved in his life kiss him on the lips. As soon as their mouths touched, he froze. Few moments later, the tip of the major's warm tongue started to ignite the same heat in his body. The rough hand slowly slid inside his thin t-shirt and roamed over his smooth skin until it touched the soft bud on his chest. The coarse fingers rolled his sensitive nipple until Tian felt the pang and recoiled. The officer withdrew from the kiss swollen lips and took the t-shirt over off his lovely. He pushed the boy's thin wrists over his head. The smooth, bare chest rose as Tian breathed heavily, tempting the major to bend down and kiss. Huba planted soft kisses along the operation scar and moved to lap the nipple that had turned dusky pink from the previous rough attention. The younger man breathed from the shudder and sensation he had never experienced before. His thin lips parted to let out a soft moan as his chest bud was being mercilessly nibbled, suckled, and pulled.
Captain, it hurts.
The tall, well-built form withdrew, but only to take his shirt off, revealing himself to the younger man. Tian had to look in his droopy brown eyes transfixed on the man on top of him, on the sun-kissed skin that made the solid muscles more prominent under the dim light. The officer's broad chest tapered down to the tight six packs like a warrior sculpture that would incite envy in any man. Tian touched the major's naked chest, long fingers skimming over his old and new scars.
Are you hurt?
He knew these were the proof of Pupa's sacrifice as he had vowed to serve and protect his country. The older man smiled gently, but it made his handsome face look mischievous. He put his hand over Tian's and slowly brought it to his torso.
It hurts more right here.
The heat from the hardness on his fingertips as the man grew thicker turned Tian's ear red, embarrassed. He wanted to withdraw his hand, but Pupa pushed it down inside his woven pants so the boy could greet his new friend. Tian's breath caught in his throat, turning away. He wasn't so naive to not know which cave this anaconda was going in. He just needed time to process and accept it. Pupa chuckled softly at the younger man's cautious reaction. He stopped teasing his lover and let the younger man withdraw. Pupa lowered himself to lovingly caress the boy's cheeks as if being bewitched, his hand vigorously stroking the body under him until his lover was pliant like wax under a flame. He took the moment when Tian was drowned in pleasure to strip the boxer from his legs. He trailed his kisses on the boy's sweaty neck to whisper in his ear.
Tian, move.
The younger man didn't understand what it meant at first, but as soon as Pupa touched him in the rear, he tensed up. The officer slowly released his breath through his mouth, trying to control his overwhelming urge, and parted the long legs to give him room. Tian started to recoil once again as an alien object was invading his body. The squirm, however, set the major's desire on fire. A thick finger pushed into the tight passage and was met with resistance.
The younger man's handsome face twisted, a picture of endless, sweet torment. As soon as the rough fingers started rolling around deep inside of him and hitting the sweet spot he had never known existed, Tian trembled, consumed by a dark desire. He panted, his body arching up as it became unbearable. Tian wound his arms around his lover's solid neck and whispered in a throat voice, "I can't do it now." Hu Pa immediately complied. He was on the verge of breaking down himself and pulled down his pants, revealing his perfect erection. He parted the long, lean legs and put the tip of his lethal weapon against the tight, soft entrance. It was as if his body was splitting in two. Tian's head tipped backward as if he wanted to scream at the top of his lungs, but only a faint sobbing came out. He bit down his lips until they bruised, trying to take his lover's large manhood that was giving him both pain and pleasure. Long fingers dug and scraped the broad back as the solid body above him started to move in and out. The burning rod was pushing hard into him, and Tian let his head fall back, letting the pleasure take over him. His sweet brown eyes gazed at the ceiling and saw the movements of two lovers who were vigorously making love. Tian breathed heavily. He never imagined he would be moaning under someone like this. Others must see it as being disgraced, but this was love. Tear juices were leaking from the hardness that was rubbed against the solid six-packs. As soon as the climax hit him, he was thrown into a spasm that shot through his body. Hu Pa pushed himself to the hilt and shot thick, hot gum until it poured out of the bruised, reddened passage. He leaned down to kiss the sweaty forehead to soothe his lover.
"Are you okay?"
the major asked in a throaty voice. As their dark desire subsided, Tian winced at the burning pain in the passage that still held the other man's hardness. He punched the thick shoulder, slightly offended. "How can I be okay? Have you ever had a torpedo shoot right through your ass?" The older man grinned, amused by the grumble.
"Thanks for the compliment."
"It wasn't a compliment." Tian tried to push the man on top of it. "Take that thing out. It's uncomfortable."
"Looks like you still have some stamina left. Want to go another round?"
"What round? No, let me go." The volunteer teacher struggled as hard as he could, but his wrists were seized and pushed into the mattress once again. The almond eyes widened as his lover's cock grew thicker inside him. He parted his lips, realizing that resistance was futile, and took the deep, hard kiss from the major. He feared that if he screamed, the whole village would march in to rescue him. So, the battle inside the mosquito net went on, and under the soft moonlight that cast her embrace to the dark earth underneath. That was the first night the two hearts and two bodies became one. The night that would live on in their memories as long as they breathed. It was nearly dawn, but the abused man still lied in his old mattress. As he turned, he winced from the pain and soreness that shot through his body. The almond eyes slowly pried open as if he just woke up after being knocked out during the night. Feeling the wetness on his body, he glanced at the massive body that was moving in the dim light. Captain, he said in a croaky voice.
"Are you feeling better?"
Hu Pa asked, concerned. He had just cleaned the fluid off the boy and put new clothes on him, a thick hand gently placed on Tian's forehead.
"You're a bit warm. I made you boiled rice. Eat and take some paracetamol."
The teacher nodded pliantly, grateful for everything the major was doing for him. He pulled the man's arm, and the officer dropped down on the mattress next to him. Tian wound his arms around the big torso to lock his man in place. The pretty face that was a little pale smiled happily as he heard a low whisper of complaint.
"You're such a kid.
My heart's cold. I need a hug. Koopa chuckled, thinking about his flirt 2 years ago.
Now you're trying to get my attention. What do you want? I must warn you that I don't get paid that much, being an officer.
I'm not asking for anything. Ian scrunched his nose and pushed his face against the hard bicep. I just want to be with you for as long as I could. The tall officer put his hand on the back of the shapely head and caressed his lover's soft hair. He started telling Tian about the good news he had received the morning before on radio from his unit at King Mangrai the Great Camp.
The entrance examination to the command in General Staff College starts at the beginning of the next month. If I get in, by the end of the month, we have to get ready to leave for Bangkok.
The city boy rolled his eyes, pondering, and smiled. This means I can continue my study in Bangkok, too. Even if they had to live in separate compounds because he had to return to his family home, at least they wouldn't be a world apart.
What if I want to return to Chiang Rai after I finished my course?
I'm coming back with you. Tian pushed himself up and put his pointed chin on the broad, solid chest, his eyes shining in the dim light in a knowing stare. You don't need to test my loyalty for you. I know that your rank is above being stationed at a border base. You need to move to a battalion now. Wherever you go, I'll be hunting you like a ghost. Do not even think of dumping me and leaving me behind. He threatened the older man, but that made the major laugh.
I'm not dumping you. You're ferocious and wild. Where else can I find such a good MWD?
MWD means military working dog. Are you calling me a dog? Tian grabbed the major's neck and shook him, but the next thing he knew, he was flipped to lie on his back. Koopa leaned down to plant a soft kiss on his smooth cheek and said the sweetest words to the man who has his heart.
I love you.
Tian froze and turned his burning face away, embarrassed. Soon after, the thin lips that were pressed tight parted to reveal a long-buried secret. I love you too. The heart inside his left chest suddenly thudded and thrummed, as if to say, and so do I. As their eyes met, the deep bond that tied them together strengthened and pulled the two lips into a deep, searing kiss as the two men poured their hearts and souls into each other. From now on, no matter what might come their way, they would never be apart again. That was the promise they'd made to the sea of 1,000 and tens of thousands of stars across the sky. Thank you to the destiny that had brought them together. Thank you, Tarfan, for the precious memory that was made ours. The end.